So, we're a little bit into brown girl dreaming right now. Last Friday, we talked about characterization, and we went over kind of what that means. So does anyone want to remind me what characterization is? Yeah? Ashley?
Characterization is like looking at all the different aspects of a character and like analyzing them, like their physical attributes, their like personality, their values, and stuff like that.
Right. Very good. Okay, so since we talked about that and we've read the first three parts of Tale of Two Maidens, or Brown Girl Dreaming, we're going to take that information of characterization and we're going to use it to move along to our next topic, which is point of view. So each character has their own point of view, and the narrator has her own point of view. And the definition of point of view, anyone want to take a guess of? Yes.
Like who's telling the story?
Mm-hmm. And to go off of that, point of view specifically is the angle of considering things, shows the opinions, feelings of the individuals involved in the situation. This mainly focuses on the narrator, but you can use it for any of the characters within the story. No.
Thank you.
So, if you want to go ahead and just write down the definition of point of view, I can read it again for you. The angle of considering things, which shows the opinions, feelings, or emotions of the individuals involved in a situation. Right? So it mainly focuses on the narrator. So our narrator here is Jacqueline, obviously. So what we're going to do is focus on our characterizations that we did last week, and we're going to talk about how those characters are affecting Jacqueline's point of view. So who can tell me one of the main characters besides Jacqueline in the story?
Maria. I don't know if it's a main character, but I think it's a main character to Jacqueline. Maria.
Yeah, her best friend?
Yep.
I would say her mother.
For sure. And another one?
Her uncle?
Uncle, yep. Uncle, Uncle Robert.
Yeah.
So, another really important one would be her grandmother. So, we talked about how her grandma is a very important part of her life because her grandma is what? What religion is she?
Jehovah's Witness.
Jehovah's Witness, right. So, because she's a Jehovah's Witness, we talked about how her characterization, she's a Jehovah's Witness, she makes the kids study religion 5 times a week. She doesn't let them, they can't say the pledge at school, they can't do Christmas parties or birthday parties or anything like that. So how do you think, what we want to start thinking about is how this character is affecting Jacqueline's life and what Jacqueline talks about. So as an example that you can write down in your paper, effects that this has on her life is that Jacqueline is not allowed to, she's not allowed to have birthday parties or Christmas parties. She's not allowed to go outside when her friends are playing on the swing set. So how do you guys think this would make Jacqueline feel if this was happening to you, guessing?
Left out.
Left out. So, Jacqueline's point of view would make her feel left out. So that's something we can write in our papers, right? So if we have character, grandmother, and then how it's affecting Jacqueline, it can make her feel left out. Anybody else have an idea? Yes.
I don't think she understands the connection between why Jehovah's Witnesses aren't able to do these things, so maybe confused.
minutes here, and we're gonna, on your paper, we can use these examples, Maria, mother, Uncle Robert, we can use any of her family members that you want, her sister Odella, if you'd like, and we're gonna talk, basically, you can work with a partner if you want to help you figure stuff out if you can't quite remember, but we're gonna write down on your paper how, write down the name of the character, and then write down how you believe it's affecting her life, that character is affecting her life. You guys can talk and work with each other. So.
Okay. I guess the mother. It's like she has a child. Well, the mother moves at the moment. She moves to New York, so that obviously has an effect on Jacqueline because when she has to move to New York, and she feels like torn between two places.
She lived in the South, she made.
Yeah, she doesn't know. She doesn't really know which one to call home. She wants the South to be home because that's where her grandma is.
Yeah.
But now, most of her family is from
New York.
Yeah.
Her uncle?
Oh, it is.
What you guys got going on?
We were just talking about Maria.
Maria's?
What about inconsistent with how she helps challenge to talk them. So there's no
witness, so she's able to sort of find herself.
Yeah.
It's not conflict of interest, it's cool. Something else.
There's
good connections.
Yeah.
Do you guys get how the mother affects her? How there's a conflict at home. She doesn't know if the North or South is her home. Because her family's spread out. But her mother also is consistent with her grandmother's beliefs and enforces them. So she doesn't like undermine everything she's been learning while she was down there. Grandmother's beliefs.
Oh, yeah, it's like a little bit of talk. A lot of small ones.
Alright, let's all come back together real quick. Looks like you guys got some real good ideas going on. So, if you want to share with the class, what did you guys have?
We thought Maria was a central character because she sort of allows Jacqueline to challenge those restrictions of the Jehovah's Witness, helps her become herself.
Okay, cool. Merrick and Ashley, what did you guys come up with?
We said that the mother creates like a conflict of home for Jacqueline.
Because her mother moves up to New York, but her grandmother's still in the South. So since she spent time in both places, she doesn't know which one to call home.
Since you guys weren't talking about the mother, if you want to write down this information too, just so you got it reinforced in your mind. Right. And then what did you have for the uncle?
Yeah, her uncle. And she has received a lot of encouragement from her uncle because her uncle always encourages her to make up her own story and has a positive impact on her.
So as we can see, all of these family members, all of these people in her family have a profound effect on Jacqueline's life, and they all make her feel different ways. So it's important to know who the characters are and what they do, but it's also important to understand how their beliefs affect Jacqueline, because she's the narrator and she's the main focus of the story. So we figure out how all of these people are affecting her life. So, for homework for next time, I want you guys to find two more characters, right? We're gonna read the first half of part 4, and I want you guys to find two more characters in Jacqueline's life and write a short description about how you think she's those characters are affecting Jacqueline's point of view in her life.
Good. Woo. The only thing I would say is, like, I would probably be more specific about what exactly you're wanting us to do, like, while you're going through everything. I mean, I think you should be more clear about, like, reinforce that, like, while you tell us to write down things, like, make sure we're actually writing it down.
Okay.
Or something like that.
Yeah, going off what Tyler said, just having explicit directions, like, at the top of the page, just to, like, even if it's for the overall worksheet, it would help people who, like, maybe weren't even paying attention to you when you explained.
Just more specific directions.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I think that since you're going back and forth between the lectern and the board, you should move stuff out of your way before class starts. That way you're not walking around it all the time.
Yeah.
When you gave us the sheet to take notes on, you were supposed to write it down. You kept going on to the next thing before we were done. So I've had to, like, go through and just keep up with what you're saying and write down what you said, told us to write.
Okay.
Yes, yeah, so it's like slow a down slow. A little.
I liked how you got down on our level though when you were checking up on us. I thought that was kind of cool. And I've read that, like, it makes the kids feel like more comfortable when teachers do that. So kudos.
I've read that as well.
It does work.
Alan Williams does it in that book society.
Yeah.
When you were at the board, I liked that you had the marker in your hand a certain way. It was like between your fingers, and you looked like a teacher.
Okay.
Really random.
All right. You did a good job projecting, like, outwards, even though you were, you know, when you,
yeah,
you were writing on the board, but you were still, you were, when you talked to us, you still turned your head around. You could hear it, because if this was a full classroom, you would have people back there, and you know they're not paying attention, unless you're yelling at them. Not yelling, but, you know,
yeah,
the way.
Speaking.
Yeah.
That was something I was trying to work on.
And it takes a lot of practice, especially those of us who tend to be more kind of quiet. Soft-spoken. Soft-spoken is the word I was looking for. But.
Good.
It seems to get on the way.
Okay. Woo.